Hi, I'm Jericho Diñera. I'm the coach of the UE Red Warriors. As a professional player, I started at the age of 21 years old and I played for Pure Foods Tender Juicy Hot Dogs. When I was chosen as one of the 25 greatest players of PBA, I think that's one of the highlights of my career as a basketball player. All of us brothers, we all started in baseball from Bronco. We call it Bronco, the Little League, ages from 8 years old up to 10. Then up all the way to Pony, it's another division, all the way to the Colt division. Then I played high school baseball. At the same time, I also played basketball during high school. Then when I moved up to varsity college basketball, I also played baseball. When I was third year high school and when they scrapped our baseball team, I shifted to basketball. It all started when we were still young, no, with my folks back in Malate. We always played there in Singalong with mga groupmates lang. Basketball, 3-on-3. But my interest really showed when my brother, older brother, played for the varsity team. And also, it's the in thing. There was Toyota Crisp at that time. Well, when I was getting those rebounds, sabi ko, I think this is for me. Sabi ko, I can rebound as many as I can. And also, parang for me, I see the people and they're so happy with it. I went to Palaro during Tugigaraw. Palaro, it was held in Tugigaraw. I was representing National Capital Region. Then it was tough. I don't know if we made it sa quarterfinals. Then after that year, after the next Palaro, I was already in basketball, in Tacloban. When you talk about Palaro, you're going up against the best of the provinces and talagang they're already screened. You can see they've been in a lot of tournaments already. And ako at that time, I was just young. And talagang yung edad is really shown na chubby. But I'm tall. I have already the physique to be in basketball and baseball. So mahirap. After Palaro, that's the time I concentrated on being a basketball player because I was already 6'4 at that time and a lot of coaches were telling me you have to stick to one sport. And then the training was also getting tougher in high school basketball, too many competitions, so that's the time I concentrated to basketball. Three, yeah. Tacloban, Tugigaraw, and Manila, I think. Alan Kaidik was there. He's with the basketball division. I was with baseball. There was Christine Jacobs, El Mamuros, Lidia De Vega, and in swimming, I saw Grace Luna. She's already good. Espinosa, Marites, there's also Richard Luna. So lahat yun. Tapos sa tennis, Jennifer Saberon, they were all good. Nandun sila lahat. Palaro is, I think, one of the top three highest elite competition in our land. Other than the PCCL and the National Open, it's Palaro is the next competition that you have to look for. And of course, they're the best of the athletes in the province. Kasi mostly players who will make the grade, normally they were already scouted in the Manila. Kasi that's how tough yung scouting when it comes to Palaro. Bago palang umabot doon, nakuha na sila. So they were able to parang naka-earmark na yon sa mga coaches. So if you're just lucky, if you can come up with a good offer, if you're in another team and they will listen to you, to your offer, and they're willing to explore those talents or those recruits, you'll be lucky kung i-entertain ka nila and they'll listen to you. And yun naman mga athletes that will be being recruited. Of course, they meet all the scouts din eh. With an open mind, they listen to you. So it's anybody's ball game when it comes to recruitment. Difficult, number one. You play twice. There are days na they play twice. You play in the morning, you play in the afternoon. So survival yun. If you lose, you go to the loser's bracket. So you have to win right away in order for you to go to the winner's bracket. You have to follow the system and of course you have to play to the best of your ability. Those who are going to compete in Palaro, you have to be ready. It's a tough competition. And if you make it, do not quit. Do not quit. And of course, other than performing in your studies, you have to do well in your studies and also you have to bring home the bacon. And if you get chosen to in the varsity sa Manila, don't grab the opportunity. If they have the opportunity to go to Manila and compete, they'll be invited in UAAP, NCAA, grab it. Because there are a lot of opportunities, of course, if you go to Manila.